Alright guys, this is a special video. This is going to be a behind the scenes look at how I did what I did. And you should know the concept by now because I've put up enough videos where you should actually understand what's trying to be accomplished here. Where I rebuilt Madden, the premise of this whole, or the concept of this whole recreation of Madden 25 is this. In this particular scenario, the teams that have never won a Super Bowl, rebuild them into championship-type teams. I mean, dominant. These are teams that haven't been dominant their whole franchise existence. So now, all of a sudden, they're going to become dominant, and the teams that have been dominant are going to be fading away. In other words, the teams that didn't have talent before are going to have talent. The teams that had talent before, that talent is going to leave. Some of it will be dramatic, and some of it will be instantaneous. But I wanted to take you behind the scenes on this because some of y'all don't believe Fat Meat is greasy. Oh, he's doing some kind of tricks. No, I'm not. No, all I did was everything you see below this video, those links, if you follow those links, you will be able to do the same thing. You'll be able to create any team. You can make a modern team a superpower. This is what we used to be able to do with Madden until they got where they put all the salary caps in and all these miscellaneous rules would pop up and you couldn't find a way to break the rule in order to get your team the way you want, except in exhibition and all that kind of stuff. Well, there's a way around that. If you do the links below, you should be able to achieve it. It's not that easy, but it's not that hard either. Okay, but let me show you right quick. I'm in the Tennessee Titans window here, user window. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the settings, franchise settings. These are the franchise settings and the league settings. So the league settings are these for this team. The difficulty is all pro. You see it? I'm not lying to you. Gonna be playing arcade style. Okay? That's really all you need to know. Because a lot of you have a hang up about what difficulty level a person is playing at. Well, difficulty levels and experience are two different things. I'm experienced at the game. So I know how to make the game less difficult, even when it's in a higher difficulty skill level. Okay? So, the Titans are a super team. Okay? They built that way. They built to win big. Okay? I'm not going to go into all of these settings, but I just wanted to show you this part because a lot of people don't believe Fat Meat is greasy. They think I'm playing on rookie, and that's why I'm blowing everybody out. No, you got to know when to call a play, when not to call a play, what defenses to play. All that kind of stuff can determine how you win. And I do not believe that a 10-year-old has to play at all-pro level. All-pro level is for young adults, anywhere from 16 to 30, okay, and older. I never play all Madden because it's almost like playing a 7-3 game. I don't like playing like that. I like to score, and I like to get interceptions and stuff like that. So I don't play where it's so hard the players don't perform at all. But All-Pro is about where I'm at right now. Okay, so I wanted to show you that right quick before I start the game. And feel free to skip this intro if it's boring you. This is for informational purposes here. Okay, so now I'm going to go into the game. And the Bears actually are built pretty good for a team that's won a Super Bowl. Most of the teams that have won a Super Bowl, they don't rank as high as the Bears do. So, but that ain't going to help them. The Titans are the Titans here, okay? They are the Giants on the field. So, theoretically, they should blow the Bears out of the water, okay? Here's the rating. And you know that this is a built team because you find very few Madden teams that out of the box that are built to be a 93. 88, 87, that's really, really good, right? Well, guess what? The Cardinals, who are the worst team in the history of the National Football League, and I never win anything, a Super Bowl, they've been there, but they haven't won one. And they've been around since 18-something. Not 19-something, 18-something. Okay? A long time, is it 18-something? Well, let me look. I better check my notes before I say that one. I might have had that one wrong. The Chicago Cardinals were created in 1898. So they've been around the longest. So they're the best team built. The second best one is Detroit. Third best is Cleveland Browns. And the fourth best is Tennessee Titans. So without further ado, I'm going to go into the game. You'd already know I should win big. If I don't, then that's on me. If I don't win, guess what? This video will never see the light of day. No, I'd put it up. I'd be embarrassed, but I'd put it up. But I'm just about guaranteeing a win for the Titans here, okay? And you know what happens when people make guarantees, don't you? So we're going to go into the game now. I just wanted to give you that quick little sequilicy, however you say it. About what's going on. And I'm going to let the announcers take over from here. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for supporting me all these years on YouTube. I really appreciate it.
Today, from Soldier Field in Chicago, it's week one of the NFL on EA Sports. As we'll see Caleb Williams and the Chicago Bears versus Dak Prescott and the Tennessee Titans.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to one of our favorite spots, venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. With my good friend Charles Davis in the booth, I'm Brandon Gauden, and the moment has finally arrived, CD. It's time to begin a new NFL season.
Partner, there's no hiding my excitement as I got ready this morning. I could not wait to get here for this game. Imagine what it's like out there on the field for those players, though. OTAs, training camp, preseason, has all led to this moment when they officially kick this one off to get the season underway.
And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. So here are the Titans now for their first drive. They'll be led out by the former Mississippi State product, the mobile quarterback Dak Prescott.
It's been a lot of fun watching him advance in his career. Many people question his ability to throw the football coming out of Mississippi State. He's conclusively answered that question. In addition, a very strong runner and an even better leader.
They show run with three tight ends here on first down. They run with a dangerous Saquon Barkley. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Now Prescott. Oh, he's going to look downfield for Barkley. Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. A big play that time for the Titans. 41 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
Prescott to throw it. Over the middle, complete. That's Henry. And the Titans are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
Boy, no problems getting down the field here on this opening drive. They've looked really sharp in the early going, and they've come up with some big plays already. Here's another. That's going to set up first and goal.
Barkley will score. Touchdown, Tennessee. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it, and catch it, and he gets it done.
Aubrey good with a PAT, and that makes the score 7-0. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. So the Bears ready to go on offense, and it's the number one overall pick leading them out, the Heisman Trophy winner from USC, Caleb Williams.
And we knew from the moment the commissioner called his name on draft night, and by the way, laid a pretty good hug on the commissioner going across the stage. But we knew he had a chance to be the starter week one. He dove right into the playbook, ingratiated himself with his teammates, and that's exactly how things have played out.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Williams. That's caught by his tight end, Dawson Knox. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. A lot of great quarterbacks from USC. Here's another one. The rookie's got a first down. They'll run here with Raheem Mostert. He'll take this to the 46. From the 46-yard line, a second down and 6. Looking to throw is Williams. That one complete. It's Tank Dell. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 30. That one good for 16 as the drive continues. On first and 10, it's Williams. That's complete to Dell. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. It'll go as a gain of 4, and it'll be second down. Another completion there. You know, we think about the draft back in the spring. He was selected, obviously, the number one overall pick. There's great money with that, but, Charles, I would think maybe an extra burden, too, or is that not that big of a deal at all?
It actually is, in the beginning of his career, an added burden, but it's one of those things that if you play well, it becomes something that justifies why you were taken number one. You're fine with that. If you don't play well, it can be an albatross.
A chance for their first points of the season here as it's first and goal. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around. Here, they even get the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You've got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
Mostert is into the end zone for a Bears touchdown.
That's a great response here in this first quarter. And what I like about it is how they put this drive together. The other guy scored quickly to start the game, but this was smart football to not feel like you have to go out and score quickly yourself. So they worked the ball down the field, took their time, and finished with the touchdown run.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And he starts his new year off on the right foot as well, as this kick is good. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it was capped off by a touchdown run from Raheem Mostert. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Titans coming back onto the field for their second drive. Perfect start to the season on their first drive last time out, able to find the end zone. Now we'll see if they can make it 2 for 2 here in week one. He'll let this go deep for St. Brown. Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. And he takes this thing way down into Chicago territory. A big play that time for the Titans. 58 yards.
It's got to feel good to hit on one of these in the first quarter of a brand new season. They're hoping this duo can really make some noise this year. And this is a great start. A big play here early in the ball game.
And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. The tackle by Cole Holcomb.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Yeah, the Titans are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1. They'll try and run for it with Barkley. And he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. Saquon Barkley. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Titans have taken the lead. So 2 drives, 2 touchdowns here in this first quarter, and he's got both of them.
Well, he's certainly setting himself up for a big game here, and I think if the play caller doesn't get in his own way, they should keep riding him the entire way of this game. Until the defense proves they can stop him, that's what I would call.
Now the extra point up and good by Aubrey. And that makes the score 14-7. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And he's going to be taken down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. Back in Chicago, ready for the second quarter. It's the Bears in possession. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they'll get another shot here with a 1st and 10. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11. Throwing is Williams. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
I'm darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
To the air on 3rd down is Williams. He'll swing this out to Mostert. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up 4th down. Here's Ryan Stonehouse now. Back deep, the dangerous Tyler Lockett. Taking it about the 16. And that one a 55-yard punt, 13 on the return. And it'll be Titan football. The offense takes the field, and we turn our attention to Saquon Barkley. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
He doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back, and that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend. Options galore here, second and a few inches. Play action now, Prescott. Well, the catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 22 yards there, a first down.
Second and short, that's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
Finding Hockenson there, an impressive catch. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Big gains in succession. Last one was over 20. This one over 30. Now, we know this offense has the potential to strike quickly, and they just bit off two huge plays on back-to-back snaps.
So on the other side of the ball, you've got to go Band of Brothers thought process.
And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Saquon Barkley. Halfway to 100 now with career touchdown number 50. And the Titans go up by two touchdowns. Aubrey now for the PAT. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Just a four-play drive that time. And it ends with a Saquon Barkley touchdown run. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Now a good running play here to start the drive. That'll net them 14 yards as they pick up the first.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
They'll fake the give. Now Williams rolling to his right, and he fends him off, and he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. To throw, it's Williams. Got his man, Dell, and taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down.
And a nice job by the two of them to not only connect on the pitch and the catch, but to carry over their practice work to the game field. They saw the adjustment by the defense, made an adjustment themselves, and picked up the first down.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. To the air, Williams. That one caught by Rice. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. A nice completion there for the first down. And Charles, you think about the quarterbacks of recent vintage that have been thrust into action week one. It's no guarantee of future success, but we sure have seen some good ones.
We certainly have, partner. How about Joe Burrow with the Bengals in 2020? He was excellent. Kyler Murray with the Cardinals. The best part about his game, has his team right at the brink of the playoffs. And Deshaun Watson has won division titles after having started from day one.
On second down, here's Williams. And they'll get this on the screen to Mostert. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's third and two. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number eight. It's third and two. They'll try and throw with Williams. He'll hit Mostert again here. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Butker's kick here is good. And that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. So the 3 points there in CD, that helps him inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. The Titans going to go back on offense here late in this first half. Already enjoying a two-score lead here late in the second quarter. Not a ton of time left. We'll see if they can work this at least into field goal range and try to get three to add on even more to their lead. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Titans. TJ Hockenson. 74 yards. And the Titans are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead.
That score that they just gave up there, that's a tough one for their defense to swallow because they've had a tough time through the first two quarters. They really were determined to get a stop there, unable to do so. That makes their comeback hopes that much more difficult.
Aubrey now for the point after. And the lead is up to 18 now. Those are the kind of drives they like on offense, from the coordinator to the quarterback, the line, everybody. One play drive and into the end zone for six. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Bears going to get one more possession in this first half. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. To throw, Williams. He'll get this into the hands of Mostert. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. A final shot before break. Williams. He's going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Merrig. And nothing comes of this last-ditch attempt at points as time will run out on this first half. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, we'll get back to you too in a bit. For now, plenty of early game action around the NFL to get you caught up on.
Well, look around the NFL. We'll have to wait for postgame because we are moving right through halftime and on to the third quarter. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. Hunter Renfrow to return it from his end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. So here's the Bears' offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20. Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there and worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it, most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
Second down, here's Mostert again. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
4 yards on the pickup, good enough to extend the drive. On first and 10, it's Algier. There he goes, left side. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. 50 yards rushing for him now in just his first 3 carries.
At halftime, he had to feel like the defense had to be in a good position. They had to feel good about themselves. They'd had this guy boxed in all game long, but after that run, that might be the breakthrough that he's looking for. Now they may have some difficulty dealing with him the rest of today.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. Take Dell from 8 yards out. And the Bears are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive of the second half. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead is down to 11 at 28-17. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And this will wind up way short of the landing zone, so that's going to move the ball all the way up to the 40-yard line. The Titans offense gears up for their first possession of the second half. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You can say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
Boy, that ball's just hanging up there waiting to be intercepted. That looked doomed from the start, but they took the deep shot anyway, and fortunately, it winds up incomplete.
Throwing again, Prescott on second and 10. He completes it to Henry. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Throwing, Prescott. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. short pass caught by Henry. They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it, and that's going to make it fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and nine. They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Bears are going to get the football back, and they're going to get it in great field position. On first and 10, it's Mostert. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Second down, here's Mostert again. And this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down for the Bears. Looking to throw. Williams. That is caught inside the five. Touchdown. Raheem Mostert. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Bears are back within a score. They'll try and throw for it. And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal. I guess the coach looked at the two-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a three-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call. And he felt good about what he had for a two-point conversion. And now they're only down three and feeling great about themselves.
Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. They'll let this go deep for St. Brown. Oh, a contested ball here and it's going to be caught. A big play that time for the Titans. 56 yards.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
They follow up that gigantic gain with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard. Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now, hotly contested in the third quarter. And, oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete. Play fake. Here's Prescott. Now a battle for the football. It's caught. It's a touchdown. Amon-Ra St. Brown. A 20-yard touchdown. And they are able to add on to their advantage. And in the red zone, I guess this is why you have a guy like that on your roster.
Without a doubt, and if you have him, you use him because he's a guy who's going to win just about every time. I don't care what the coverage is.
Now the Titans leaving the offense out there. They'll go for two. They're going to run it with Barkley. And he will get into the end zone. So the lead stretches from 9 up to 11. Needed a couple yards for the two-point try. They go to the ground game, and it works.
And sometimes it's the exact right thing to do because a lot of teams play you for the pass, so you spread people out, decide to run the football. You often find good running lanes.
From his end zone, here's Renfrow. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Chicago offense set to get started. A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
From the 32-yard line now, here's second and six. Working out of the gun, Williams. It's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Here's a handoff to Mostert running left. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 11 yards there, just like last play. They held him in check in the first half, but that's his longest carry of the game right there.
So would this be the definition of fresh legs since he didn't get much done in the first half? Now he has a great opportunity. He's taking full advantage of it.
Back now at Soldier Field. It's Bears football, but they trail on the scoreboard as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter. A Mostert to first down carry. This will wind up only getting him a couple. And it'll bring up second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line.
And here's a spot where this offense says, we got to start making something happen. We're down two scores. It's the fourth quarter. We've got to start moving with some urgency. And here's a big play that gives them a ray of hope that they can get back in this one.
And here he'll get it down to the 7. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. The gun. Here's Williams. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Hunter Renfrow, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Bears have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. It's a run with Mostert, but he will not get in here. He stopped up short of the goal line, and this will remain a 5-point game. Defensively, certainly not fooled there. Play started at the 2, and he was tackled at the 2.
That has to feel good for them. Not happy about having given up the touchdown, but stopping the 2-point conversion gives them a little bit of a lift as they head to the bench.
And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. We get a look at Amon-Ra St. Brown as his offense readies for the next drive.
And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that...
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked up by DJ Reed. And the Bears are right back in this football game.
Their passing game has been spectacular this afternoon. Finally, a win for the defense.
You think maybe there was an adjustment there. Finally gained a measure of, I don't even know if you call it revenge, but got a play done against him, and that's been difficult for them all game long.
And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
Ball on the 35. Here comes 2nd and 5. Back to throw. Williams. Little pitch and catch to the tight end, Knox. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. From the gun, a run with Mostert. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Levante David in on the tackle. Here's 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Little pitch and catch to the tight end, Knox. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a 3rd down. So a nice throw there. And, CD, I'd have to think you've been impressed with what you've seen thus far here in his debut.
Now, you know me well. I have been impressed because what I've seen is him starting to understand how to play the game in a short amount of time. The dazzling plays, they'll come with experience. But right now, we're seeing him handle the game, make all the smart plays and the right reads.
He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead.
Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
And that's just an ideal run to start this drive because they're in full ball control mode now, so if you keep ripping off 7, 8, 9 yards of carry, you're going to have a great chance of finishing off this game.
Prescott now. And, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
And this is going to be a Titans first down as he gets this up past the 30 to the 32. 56 yards for him on the ground now and 3 touchdowns to go along with it.
So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here with Barkley. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. Prescott here to throw. And this nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. Well, a turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And on 3rd and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive. Prescott. Pass taken in by his big tight end. Now the Bears will use their 3rd and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Up the middle with Barkley. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
Yeah. They picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete.
They may be snapping a ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for 3 and not giving up 6.
And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8.
I have to laugh a little bit because he actually handed it off. I thought with the 2 touchdown passes he's thrown in this one already, he'd go ahead and fling and try and get a 3rd one.
Yeah, now from this spot on 3rd down, I think he'd probably throw it here.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it. They won't even send in a running play here, I don't believe. I think they go ahead and try and throw it for a touchdown.
Third down, goal to go from the 8. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field. Here we go, a big play and a tight game late. They're going on fourth and goal. Here's Prescott. Fighting through pressure. And he will not get away. He's sacked back around the 3-yard line. Well, CD, always a little extra excitement for week one, and one of our early window games here in week one on a Sunday comes to a close. Good to be back in the booth with you, my friend.
And it's good to be back in the booth with you as well. And we know that not everyone's going to start the season 1-0, right? Half the league is going to have a loss on their record, but everyone's going to have to build off of that opener. And how many coaches tell us every single year, you make your most progress between week one and week two. We'll see how both of these teams progress the rest of this season.
So for Tennessee, hey, you get a win, you get it on the road. You can't ask for much more than that to start the year. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Bears, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to Houston to take on the Texans. So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports.